Welcome to today's Rhapsody of Realities, written by Pastor Chris Oyakhilome, Saturday 24th, October 2020. Have the rapture in focus. And now, little children, abide in him, that when he shall appear, we may have confidence and not be ashamed before him at his coming. 1 John chapter 2, verse 28. The rapture of the church is closer than ever. We are in the closing moments or final times of the signs before the Lord's appearing. It's important that you ready for him. 1 Thessalonians chapter 4, verse 16 to 17 says, "The dead in Christ shall rise first, and those who are alive and remain shall be caught up together with them to meet the Lord in the air." The question is, are you in Christ? If you are, then you are one of the many the Lord is coming to receive unto himself. If, however, you are not, you have to give your heart to Christ right away before, by confessing his lordship over your life. The Bible says, Christ was once offered to bear the sins of many, and unto them that look for him shall he appear a second time without sin unto salvation. Hebrews chapter 9, verse 28. Acts chapter 1, verse 9 to 11 tells us about his ascension into heaven. While the disciples stood gazing in awe, as he levitated, two angels appeared to them and said, "This same Jesus who has been received from you into heaven will come back in the same way you have seen him go into heaven." Acts chapter 1, verse 11. This is the reason we are preaching the gospel around the world. The whole world needs to know that the rapture of the church is imminent. The Master is coming soon. He said in John chapter 14, verse 3, "I will come again and receive you unto myself, that where I am, there ye may be also." The Apostle Peter, referring to the day of the Lord and the event that will herald his coming, said, "But the day of the Lord will come as a thief in the night, in the which the heavens shall pass away with a great noise, and the elements shall melt with fervent heat, the earth also, and the works that are therein shall be burnt up. Seeing then that all these things shall be dissolved, what manner of persons ought ye to be in all holy conversation and godliness?" 2 Peter chapter 3, verse 10 to 11. Have the rapture in focus. Live every day as one expecting the Master. Carry that consciousness in your heart at all times. Walk in love, walk in righteousness. And while you are getting yourself ready, help those around you to get ready, as well as preaching and teaching them God's word. Prayer. I'm awake and alert in the spirit, fervent in good works, being prepared by the Master's love. his word and my expectation of his soon return. I am fully convinced that the gospel is God's saving power to everyone who believes. I am resolute in my pursuit for the souls of men. Today, as this glorious gospel is preached around the world, many are snatched out of the kingdom of darkness into the glorious liberty of the sons of God. In Jesus' name, amen. Further study. Matthew chapter 24, verse 14. Romans chapter 13, verse 11 to 14. Meditate on these words. Give yourself wholly to them, that your profiting may appear unto all. Have a blessed day.